My dear brothers and sisters, I would just want to seize this opportunity to thank each and every one of you who have been dedicated, loyal, and have been with us from the beginning of the year to this very hour. I just want to tell you that you have been a good Christian. You have been a good follower of Christ. All the challenges we have been through to this very hour, the Lord was faithful and good to us. You might not have been where you wanted to be, but note one thing. If you are alive, and I am alive, and many of our family members are alive, it's because God is not yet finished with us. So don't give up. I pray and I decree and declare, as you have been faithful up to this very hour, know that one day in the presence of God is more than the wasted time out of the presence of God. And your being faithful to God will not be in vain. For remember, it's not the first that have succeeded. Because the Bible makes us understand that the first shall be the last, and the last shall be the first. When they start a race, there are so many people on the starting line. But he that endures to the end and cross the finishing line is the one that get the prize. I want to appreciate and thank you heartily from my heart that we have all succeeded to get to this very point. It's not yet finished. We still have some few days to cross over to 2022. And I'm not moved because I know that the faith, he that is in you, is greater than the challenges that we have been through to this very hour. Yes, uncertainty will come. Challenges will come. But the God that we serve is greater than the challenges that we have been going through. The bread of life that we breathe is better than all the challenges. So be faithful, remain focused, remain resilient. Yes, don't be moved by the things you hear, the things you read, or the things that are happening around you. So many people that you started with that were not in accordance with you or don't share the same view with you have gone. But those who value you for who you are still with you. So I pray that God should open your spirit of understanding, give you wisdom from above to always be moved by the thing that is written on the tablet of your hearts, but not the things that happen in the external. The eyes is very deceitful. Sometimes we see things that are not even there. It comes from our imagination. And that is why the Bible is telling us in Romans 12, verses 1 and 2, it says that what? That we should present our body as a living sacrifice. And we should not conform into this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind. Meaning what? We should let go malice, let go all things that would entangle us to fall short of the glory of God and focus on our goal, focus on our vision. Leave all those who are consuming your time aside and focus. When you cross to 2022, be a different person. Don't be the same person that you were in 2020 and you will see the glory of God in your life. Life after that, you can then enjoy it there. But I will encourage you to start enjoying your salvation from earth. Now, not when you close your eyes. My brothers and sisters, I just want to thank you for all the support, for being there with me. Sometimes I might not have been good with you. I might have neglected you, but just know that all of us are human. There are challenges that comes. But one thing I know for sure, that the work I do, I don't do it for myself. I don't do it to take glory. I do it to serve God. For he says that when he build the house, he is the greatest builder. Because if the Lord is not the builder, those who build are building in vain, according to Psalms 127, verse 1. If he's not the watchman that watches over the city, those who watch over the city, they are doing it in vain. For we get up early in the morning, we work many jobs, but we end up eating the bread of our sorrows. But he gives sleep to his beloved. And he says in Jeremiah 29, verse 11, he says that he knows the plan that he has for you and for me. Not of evil, but to bless us, give us an unexpected end, give us hope. My brother and sister, seek God with all your heart, with all your soul, with everything. He has been faithful to you, has been faithful to me. And this new year that is coming, I pray that it should be a new year of open doors. Let blessing locate you. Let all the things that you could not achieve in this year locate you next year. And so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. Remain blessed and be focused. Amen.